Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Hi, how are you all? Donny here is ready to share stories. Of course, it's still on your favorite podcast. Namely podcast, stories about your lectures, me, us. Of course, it's still as usual. Donny will accompany your free time with unique stories related to lectures, whether online or offline, which will certainly be very exciting if we discuss. Happy watch and happy listening. Today, we have three special guests from BTD Gang. Please welcome to Siti Nuraini as Nura. Hello.
Hello, guys.
And Zirilia Fatia Zikrilia as Jiril. Hello.
Hello, everyone.
And the last one, Zahra Nurbaiduri as Jahe.
Hello.
Okay, let's go. Hello, how are you guys?
Alhamdulillah, I'm good.
Glad to be invited to this phenomenal podcast.
Yes, I'm really very happy and excited to this podcast.
I'm speechless because I'm happy to be invited to this podcast.
Wow, it's amazing how passionate this BTD. It's now, I will start to enter the topic of conversation. Namely, how do you think about online and offline school? The first, Jahe.
Okay, thank you, Donny. My response to online or offline school is that both of them have their own shortcomings and weaknesses. It's just a matter of how we absorb to knowledge so that in enters the brain. For offline schools, there is more interaction with friends and teachers, and the lack is that they may be more tired and tired easily. For online school, it is more flexible and does not take much time. The lack is that it is difficult to interact if you find difficulties in learning. If I had to choose, I would not want both. I want to sleep and play, but if I insist, I will choose offline school because it is more adrenaline challenging. Thank you.
Wow, thanks for the response, Jahe. And it can be said that Ginger, Jahe, people just follow it online or offline, but Jahe likes to sleep. So if you are not lazy, Jahe will be more inclined to be offline because it challenges your adrenaline. Well, next time and Julia.
Thank you, Mr. Donny. I agree with what Jahe said, that offline or online learning has its advantages and disadvantages. But how do we position ourselves so that both are equally effective? Because from what I feel that online schools, we spend a little more time and we don't need to be tired of leaving the house to go to campus. But unfortunately, online learning is not easy to understand because students and lecturers do not meet in person. But offline learning can be more effective because it's easy to interact. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Jiril. It's almost the same regarding the answer where there is not emphasis on going online or offline. When talking about learning, Zirel will prefer you offline because it is effective for interaction directly. And okay, to the next, Nura, welcome.
Thanks to the host. According to my response regarding online and offline lecture, there are many differences. Starting from interaction with classmates and lecturer, When online, I may leave a lot Zoom during learning. Even I myself often fall asleep. And when offline, it's fun separately, and we can know what the character of our classmates are like. And then in terms of benefits, when online, we can study and do our other jobs. For example, cleaning at home, shopping, even working part-time. Effective in doing it compared to being completely offline in class, we only focus on things around campus. So if you are asked to choose, I'd rather get married. Who knows if we get married, college assignment can be helped. So yes, we are good. Studying, shopping, living expense will be borne by my husband. Flying is also good together or not alone. Maybe that's how it is for me.
Amazing, Siti. Wow. Thank you, Siti. The answer is almost the same regarding online or offline. But there is a point that we have to emphasize, namely getting married. Married. Oh, it's amazing, Siti. Siti Dirte herself wants to get married in the hope that her husband can help. I hope that what Siti hopes will come true. Well, guys, moving on the next question. What is your opinion, Zirilia, about your favorite subject and why it can be your favorite, whether in terms of the lecture or the subject?
Okay, my favorite course in this semester is statistic. The reason why I like statistic, because apart from the good lectures, the material is also easy to understand even though learning is still online.
Wow, it's amazing. For me, statistics to be a study hard. Can Jirila test us to study statistics later? Okay, next the question for Zahra. What is Zahra's favorite lecture on campus?
Maybe my favorite lecturer is Mr. Dadang Hussein Sabana, because even though he's always joking, but he is still teaches well.
Wow, I agree with you, Zahra. Is Pak Dadang is really cool teacher like that. Okay, the next question for Nora. What are you busy with right now, Nora? Like the job or organization you belong to? Can you tell a little story on this podcast?
Okay, if I'm still busy joining organization on campus, both external and internal organization are both active. Especially now in external organization, there are so many activities and programs that must be carried out.
Wow, amazing. Super busy, Nora, and Nora is activist on campus. Okay, guys, last question for all of you. What will you do after graduation? Starting from Zirilia, please.
What I want to do when I graduate from college is get a good job, be rich, make the people around me happy, and get married.
Okay, thank you, Zirilia. I hope you're happy. And the next, Nora, please.
After graduating from bachelor degree, maybe I will start a business, and I really want to do master, but I'm still not sure. But if you want to start a business, it's been designed from now on and has a concept. It's just a matter of when you want to start.
Okay. Thanks to Nora. Hopefully later the business plan will be ready. Mature and quickly start in business. Okay, and the next, Yahra, please.
After graduation, I want to continue school and work. If there is a soulmate, I want to get married maybe.
Okay, thanks to Yahra. Hopefully, later when Jahek continues to graduate or look for a job, he will get the best. Well, concluded from the dear speaker, we want a good job, continue to have master's degree in business and end up being rich and getting happy. But when you will get or wants, get it all, you have to study seriously and really, whether is online or offline lecture, so that once the response from our guest star, friends, so we can conclude that maybe whether it's online or offline, there are a lot of activities and useful things to get. So once the response from friends at home is the same as guest star, where you have different answer comes below. Okay, guys, maybe there's no podcast this time about online and offline lectures. What's our next podcast? See you next time, guys. See you.
See you. Bye, guys.
I'm sorry for have a mistake. Thank you for watching and listening. Wabillahi taufik wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.